Hello friends, I am Dr. Anirudh Vij and I am a general and laparoscopic surgeon, and today we will be discussing about the common problem of kidney stones. The kidneys are paired organs which are present inside our abdominal cavity on either side of the lumbar spine, and they are connected by means of narrow tubes known as ureters to the urinary bladder. The kidneys function for filtration of the blood and production of urine. The urine which is produced by the kidneys flows down the ureters into the urinary bladder, where it is stored for some time after being voided out through the urethra. Stones can form in any part of the urinary tract, right from the kidneys to the ureters to the urinary bladder, and can even get obstructed in the urethra. Stones are very common in the Indian population, and they can occur in all age groups and can occur both in males as well as females. The most common predisposing factor for formation of kidney stones is due to inadequate water intake. Other common factors which lead to production of stones may be any obstruction in the urinary tract, or some infections, or some genetic predispositions, or they can form as a result of some metabolic conditions, or even some unknown factors. The most common symptom for a stone present within the urinary tract is pain. The site of pain depends upon the location of the stone. When the stone is present within the kidney or the upper part of the urinary tract, the pain is usually located in the loin area, which refers to the waist area, and it usually radiates backwards. When the stone is present in the lower part of the urinary tract, like the ureter or the urinary bladder, the pain radiates downwards to the groin, and in the males, it can radiate towards the testicles. Besides pain, the patient experiences a sense of nausea and may vomit when the episode of pain starts. Also, there may be urinary complaints like increased frequency of micturition, dribbling of urine, and passage of blood in the urine. These symptoms, together with the clinical history of previous such complaints, makes the diagnosis of stone likely. The diagnosis is confirmed with the help of X-ray of the abdomen or an ultrasound of the abdomen. Most of the kidney stones can be picked up on the X-ray because 80% of these stones are radio opaque. The X-ray will show us the site of the stones, the number, as well as the size of the stones, and an ultrasound can provide additional information such as the presence of swelling in the kidney as well as the presence of swelling in the ureters. Sometimes small stones are not able to be picked up by X-ray or ultrasound. In these cases, we may require a CT scan of the abdomen, which can pick up the small stones and provide a detailed anatomy of the entire kidney as well as the urinary tract for performance of the surgical intervention. So, what is the treatment for these kidney stones? Most of these stones are small and are asymptomatic or give rise to minimal symptoms, and these can be treated medically. When the stone is smaller than 6 mm in size and is not causing any obstruction to the passage of urine, it can be left alone. Occasionally, the patient may require painkillers for a severe bout of pain, but usually these stones do not give rise to severe symptoms and pass out spontaneously through the urinary tract and out of the body. But when the stones attain a larger size, more than 6 to 8 millimeters in size, and when they cause obstruction to the pathway of urine, then they require surgical removal. Stones which are present within the kidney can be removed with the help of a procedure which is known as PCNL, or percutaneous nephrolithotomy. In this procedure, a small puncture is made in the abdomen overlying the site of the stone, and the kidney is directly punctured and the stone is extracted, either in toto or it can be fragmented with the help of a machine known as a lithotripter, and then the stone can be taken out piece by piece. If the stone is present lower in the urinary tract, like the ureter or the urinary bladder, it need not be removed with the help of a skin puncture. Rather, a small instrument known as a cystoscope or a ureteroscope can be passed directly through the urethral opening, and then the stone can be extracted directly from the body without any external skin incision. After such a surgery for a kidney stone, a ureteric stent is usually placed and left there for 4 to 6 weeks to help the swelling of the kidneys to come down. A urinary catheter or a urine tube is also placed at the time of surgery, which is removed after 24 hours. And the ureteric stent can be removed after 4 to 6 weeks. The treatment for kidney stones has now become very straightforward and very advanced, so that patients can have a faster recovery and they can return to normal activities within 2 to 3 days.